People don't react to me all the time. Catastrophizer. Maybe you're somebody who's always asking in doom and gloom. What if? I was especially hearing this during the layoffs in my school district, Ewing Unified School District. People were, their seniority, people were kind of up there on the list and probably wouldn't be touched by the layoffs, but they were saying things like, what if I get the pink slip? And, there goes my car, there goes my house. I mean, people were obsessing about this. What if? Emotional reasoning. You wake up, for example, you feel fat. I step on the scale, it still says 120, but I feel fat. Therefore, I'm fat. That's emotional reasoning. Letting your emotions be your logic. Oh my God, that means. Next one, fortune telling. Fortune telling. Someone who is predicting an outcome. I've always been a nervous person, so I can't change. I will always be a nervous person. That will always be my future. Dangerous thinking. Should statements. We all often hear on and should in our thinking process. I remember this as plain as it was yesterday. I think I was in the eighth grade, and there was a student in the seventh grade. She was a spectacular, vivacious young lady who thought erroneously that she had to get A's all the time. That was just something that she just knew, that she just had to do it. Well, she pretty much got A's most of her life, but I don't know what subject it was, but this time she got a B. This is very extreme, but the girl killed herself. And it blew all of our minds because we didn't know how extreme that was. In her mind, she somehow thought an A meant that she was a great person and that a B was just something intolerable, and that just blew our minds. Magnifying. Again, that's similar to one of the other ones. Do you exaggerate the negative? Minimizing the positive. And that's always you hear about the glass being half full or half empty, that kind of thing. It's all about our focus. What we focus on is really what we become ultimately. We keep focusing on the negative. Guess what? I can't find a reason to get out of bed the next morning if I'm that negative. If I focus on the positive, people can be in trying circumstances and say, you know what? There's a reason to live. It's all about your outlook. For me, as like I said before, I know that I tend to be a personal life. So I have my antennae up all the time. And when I see that I'm personalizing, I cut it like a weed whacker. Right there, immediately, I start dealing with it because I don't want it to fester, you see. If I'm someone who always sees the negative, then I have to retrain my brain to begin to see what's the silver lining in a situation. This stuff is work. I'm not going to even say that it's not work, but it's the kind of work that we put in at the gym, right? I mean, we all want abs, right? We all want to lose that 25 pounds, right? And if you look at society, and you look at the TV, or you look at websites, that's all they talk about. The new infomercial is on the new equipment that's going to create the abs like yesterday. We put emphasis on our health. We need to put emphasis on our emotional health, too. Yes.
Can you make any suggestions about training the brain, but encouraging, for instance, your children to change train their brain without it becoming should, ought to?
Absolutely, absolutely. And when I show you the technique, this technique that I'm going to share with you is good for a little child, and if they're willing, an 85-year-old person. It's very simple. And it's about your willingness to use it. That's all. Okay.